Elijah.
Let my enemies destroy themselves.
I believe this is your word that you've been waiting for all night. Darwin, where are you?
See it. I have prayed for somebody, any power that I've been oppressing you, let fire disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Let your amen roar like thunder. Let your amen roar like thunder. Let your amen roar like thunder. Somebody shall fire.
I want to thank God for what God has done for me. My name is Esther Ime Oko. During December deliverance, I came here with a severe pain in my breast. I didn't know the source. So after the program, I went back. After 1 week, I was still on the fire. So I slept one night and I saw myself in the church. Pastor was there. They were singing and this prayer warfare. They were singing and singing the singing song. Inside me, outside me, all around me, Holy Ghost fire. I was singing it seriously, and as I was singing, I saw a baby boy fell out from my body, and I was surprised. That was when I called the pastor, "Pastor, please, come and see what's going on." Everybody was just singing, and when pastor came, he saw the baby, and he was saying, "Who are you? Show yourself. Who are you? Show yourself." And the baby refused, and he changed the song. You will begin your walk. Come and perfect your walk. So as we're singing it, the baby turned to an old woman. When she got up, she said, "Why are you people disturbing me? I was meant to stay in her body, and why are you people chasing me out?" Pastor said, "Who asked you to come out?" He said, "I can't just stay because her body is too hot." And you know, those of us that joined the December deliverance, you know, it was very hot. I was feeling hot. So he went, and pastor said, "Okay, now go." She said, "No, she's not leaving." Pastor said, "You are lying. You must leave." So as pastor was telling her to leave, she said, "No." Pastor sang another song again, that honors of you will live should carry their load. They were singing. He said, "Okay, I will leave." But she threw one black, this 20 naira first tag bag, said, "Take it, this is your own." Pastor blocked her and told her, "You're not leaving. What is inside that bag?" He said, "I don't know. It's her belonging. Let her take it." He said, "Let me know first." She now said, "It's her belonging." Pastor said, "No, you must take it or you tell us what's inside the bag." So they shouted, "Fire, fire, fire," and she picked the bag. Immediately she grabbed the bag. She was flinking the bag this way and she walked out from the door and she came mad. I want to thank God for restoring. And that was not the end of it. When I woke up, the pain, because I came to deliverance with the pain and I was just managing. When I woke up, I didn't feel the pains again. After 1 week, I went to my place of work. My friend were asking me, "Miss Esther, what kind of cream are you using? What kind of soap?" Your body has changed. So I want to thank God for changing my search. Glory be to God.
Praise the Lord. I want to testify the goodness of God in my life. My name is Grace Patrick Girl. I came here on Sunday because I was having severe pains in my body. I came and met pastor, and pastor told me I should come and enter deliverance. That one day that I came and entered deliverance was the day I supposed to went to hospital because I was having lump in my breast. But today I give God the glory. Because the pains I felt that day was severe, and now I'm not feeling the pains again. To God be the glory.
Praise the name of the Lord. I first of all give God glory before I start giving my testimony. I thank God this morning. Okay, my name is Chinyere Esther Chukwu. I thank God this morning because before I came here, I was facing a lot of challenges, of which I don't know. I started coming here last year, December. But as I come, when I go home, the thing will intensify. I continue praying. I say, "God, what is happening?" In this very matter, this time, I say, God, I'm going to go, I'll be going, maybe as the pastor laid down rules that we are going to follow. But Father, I am going here. I will go 7 days dry to know whether I have solution to the problem. And I thank God since Monday I came here, I never drink a drop of water. I never eat food, anything. I never break any day till now I'm standing here. And I thank God who gave me the strength. Everything we are doing here, I'll be following. Sometime I will go outside and I stay. I have my strength. And I'm thanking God, this great God of heaven on earth, that has showed me mercy. 3 days, 7 days, I have gone through. I came here with the spirit, enemy cast spirit of madness. That one was obvious. That I will not know myself. When you are talking to me, people will tell me what. I will tell them, what are you saying? I will be off. I will tune off. Until I will realize myself again. And some people started calling me, see what I'm seeing, or pray hard though. I tell them I have seen it, but I'll be battling. I'll be praying. I'll be asking God to help me. I don't know where spirit of madness in my lineage. We have no counted madness. Where will madness come on me? What have I done? That one pass, I was struggling with it. Stroke came. I don't know where spirit of stroke came on me. I was suffering this. Since last year, I will lie down. Even when I was here, I will be praying. Immediately, I close my eyes to sleep. From here, my hands will die off with my legs. I will be shouting, Jesus. I will be shouting, Jesus. Until the thing will leave me, do me, me, and leave. For these 2 years, as I came here, God started his work in my life. As I was undergoing this day, not only that, let me just say it before I conclude everything, what happened. Yes. I know. Praise the Lord. Another one is the spirit of death. That one is obvious too. I was battling with. But you know, again, I had eyes problem. Growth started growing on my eyes. Over 10 years. It was 2013. Any doctor I went to, they said there is no solution, no. The last I went at a teaching in a hospital in my state, Ebonyi state, they gathered all the doctors on my behalf. This doctor, they will say, this one, what do you say? This one, what do you say concerning her? I burst in tears. I cry out my heart. I say, that means that this thing doesn't have solution. God, what will I do? I came back to Port Harcourt. They said there's no solution. If they tamper with my eyes will go. That they have done everything. They have used all their gadgets and checked my eyes. They say if they tamper with it, my eyes is gone. I came back to Port Harcourt. One man saw me say, sister, I was walking on the road. This thing happened to your eyes. I have a doctor that can operate on it. I said, eh? That means there's a solution for me. I started shouting. I said, where is the place? He directed me. I went straight ahead. And I showed to the doctor. The doctor said, hey, sister, my God will do it. I say, amen, sir. I went through the operation. It was something else. But God saw me through. Since then, 2013, I started having eyes problem. They wash, give me a lens after then. I can't read again. I was in the school. I can't read again. I was crying until they washed the eyes. But let me
here, yes, happened?
Everything. Conclusively now, that since Monday I came here, my eyeglass, I have not used it for 1 day. I'm using my clear eyes to read even my tiniest Bible. Till now, my tiniest Bible, I read it without my eyes glass. That's number one. The madness, I saw God sending it away. The stroke has left me. On Friday, I just feel sensation in me. I say I have not eaten, I have not drank. Only Tuesday I passed out something. That was last. My urine was just a drop. But on Friday, I was sitting down here. All my body began to vibrate, everything in me. I started feeling stolen. I said, what is this? I rushed down to Obon's house. I wanted to go through. My spirit said, use waterproof. When I use waterproof, my brothers and sisters, what I pass out, I started crying. I said, God, how great are you? How great are you, Lord? Ebola, I don't know whether it's a fat. I don't know, black things, lumps, like, I can't imagine how the thing was. It was smelling. I just touched it with smoke. Smelling, I cannot know. Again, yesterday, after purging, because I don't want to purge, after purging, my dear brother and sister, come and see what I passed through again. It was a thick, obono soup. If you see the one, I passed out. And since then, my body was like, there is a cold water in me. I said, my God,
praise God. Brethren, I thank God for what God has done. My name is Sendam Ratman Great. What brought me to this deliverance was my business. My business was booming. Everybody were congratulating me. I did never know how I shine in this few time. So before I know the business, my first manager went away. The second one went. My staff, almost 15 of them, they started disappearing. Because when I just said, I don't know what was going on. So I got a job. I got a contract last July. So running millions of naira. Before I know the job, I could not meet up the supply. Things were going on. Things were like bad. So the people that maybe I used to hire to supply, main supply for me, all of them disappointed. I bought my own truck. When I brought the truck, I wanted to raise the truck so that he can carry loads. Before I know, not that there's no money, but to go to the place and get the truck, I don't know, something hold me down, I could not go. When I even tried to pay them double, no driver again, I cannot see driver. But to God be the glory, when I was here yesterday, I had not go anywhere, but God arranged a driver. My truck that is in the park, where nothing happened to it, I could not go. You know, I took it. When I was leaving here yesterday to home, to my factory, I saw my driver on the road with the truck. What happened? This is a truck I bought new engine. Everything is working. He said overheating. Overheating is how? I called the mechanic. When I was passing, Holy Spirit told me, say, are you not with anointing oil? I put anointing oil. Everything is okay. My motor is now working. Okay. Then, while I was here, I thought I have lost that contract. I dreamed when I was up there, the pastor, they were trying to give me contract to sign. Some people came that I'm not worthy. Because even physically, when people come to my place, they say, where director? When they say this is me, they don't believe. When sometimes they won't give me money, they say they cannot give you money. Say you don't deserve this kind of money. How you be? I say that is my nature. That is how I am. So they will call my phone number, call my complimentary card to confirm before they give me money. So I dream as they want to give me contract. They say, no, don't give him. This one cannot handle it. Then our pastor here appear and say, you must give it to him. He deserves it. So when I reach house, when I reach my factory yesterday, my manager told me, say that work that they want to take it, that they have revived it, I say I'm the one to supply. Again, why we're here, the place I got my second line for my factory, the man is a occultic man, which all of us know, but I told him, me, I third mountain of fire, occultic person cannot do me anything. So, to get breakthrough, there was when we were praying, a day before yesterday, the man now was calling me while I was praying, doing deliverance. So, I told my friend that's sitting there, I said, why this occultic man is calling me? I said, sir, what happened? He said, right man, what has happened? Are you, what is going on? I said, nothing. I said, why do you call me? You have not been calling me. But that place, as one of my manager left that place, one boy connived to sell some of my property. I took this, my friend, go there. While I was sitting down from the same place I have not been making through for the second place, a person called me again for a business that is worth enough and huge amount of money. Yes. Yes. And again, The second thing that bothers me, this my friend, always we were arguing. So I don't know what came over me. I just hate women. Then I'll say I will not marry. That they should find money for me. I should give money to someone to go and buy male child for me. My friend will tell me, me and my friend will be arguing outside. Say for me to pray about wife is the last prayer I go pray. God forbid. Saying a woman is supposed to pray for husband. Say if na money I go pray for. So I told him, say, what? I don't know why pastor was teaching here on the stage. Then I want to say, maybe I have a problem. That is why the thing were happening like this. So that mentality, he told me, so that mentality don't change.
Amen. Oga Komako. If you are clapping for Jesus, please do. You can stand and appreciate him. Put those hands together for the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Amen. How many of you were here when this man had that dream in Deliverance? I said, okay, come out. Come fast, come fast. Stay here. Because I was so sure that the kind of money that will enter his hand, it's not. I said, okay, come on, come out. See, and I asked him, who did you see? He said, he saw me. Okay, good. So God that used me to tell them to give you the job knows that we have something to do here. I want to pray for somebody. Anything that belongs to you that somebody is sitting upon, they shall be unseated by fire in the name of Jesus. Let your amen roar like thunder, somebody. Anything you have been denied, anything you have been denied that they won't give it to you, I decree now, let that fellow go under pressure. Under 24 hours. Let them release your portion in the name of Jesus. Let your amen roar like thunder, somebody. Even an occultic man began to call. I want to pray for somebody who understands this mystery very well. God will use your enemy to favor you. I said, God will use your full-time enemy to favor you. Let your amen roar like thunder, somebody. Somebody shall fire. Put your hands together for Jesus. You know what married before? You know what married before? But your mentality don't change. If you choose one year before you. If you you know, I called you out and I anoint your hand. If you follow what God asks you to do, you've not seen anything yet. And you marry sharp, sharp. Don't bother yourself. Just pray, Lord, show me. He will give you clear revelation. And you will see not a wife, a sister, a mother, and a friend. Amen. Put your hands together for Jesus. Please. And it's permanent in Jesus' name. Before you continue, there was a sister. Where's that? Immaculata, where are you? Immaculata, where are you? Okay. That sister that testified that they told her she has breast cancer. They wanted to cut off the breast in teaching hospital. They came with the material they have bought. Then she came to see me. It was on Sunday. I said to her, please, don't allow them to cut her breast. They have bought the material. You can give her my name. She came to my office with the, I'm not a doctor, the apparatus. Everything that is required for the operation, they have bought them. And she said, no, come. Let's come to the church and see pastor. And the woman, the sister was crying profusely. And she said, no, she was telling her, let them go and do it. And I asked her, do you want them to cut off your breast? that. He said, no. I said, now why you say they should do it? Don't you think God can heal you? Please, don't just believe all doctor reports. Try your best. There are many. You had that sister. She had the same problem. But after the deliverance, she saw herself back in the church, and prayer was going on. A small chap jumped out of her and turned into an old woman. That was the prayer. If she has gone to hospital, they would tell her, doctor, we see cancer. But it was a demon. Another sister here will testify. I don't know if she's here. Look at her there. The power that is troubling her said, I gave her enemy, not her, breast cancer. And she says she'll be having the pain in her breast. Another person, I don't know if she's here now. The demon spoke again. I gave her sugar problem. You see, I've come to realize that most of the so-called affliction, they were affliction orchestrated by also wickedness and evil power. So don't just see. And I've seen it many times when they come with the report, I tell them, I say, please pass through one or two deliverance. Then if after two, three deliverance, it didn't go, it might be a natural thing that needs medical attention. And I want to say this, 80% never go through that operation. 80. When I say 80, I know what I'm telling you. 80. All of a sudden, that signs, those symptoms, you heard that they said, as skin change. Which means the signs of cancer has begun to manifest. She has begun to go pale, maybe all those signs coming up. But immediately after the deliverance, people began to say, you have changed, you have changed, you have changed. I want to pray for somebody. Anything sucking your blood gradually, if your amen can be very loud, let that thing die. In the name of Jesus. Let your amen roll like thunder, somebody. Anything that wants to sniff life out of your destiny, anything that wants to squeeze life out of you, anything that wants to strangulate your destiny, evil power of father's house, mother's house, ancestral spirit, let them die suddenly in the name of Jesus. Let your amen roar like thunder, somebody. Somebody lift up your right hand and declare, I am free.
I am free.
Put those hands together for Jesus.
My name is Inyobo Umo. I just want to appreciate the name of the Lord Almighty during my December deliverance 2015. That was the last deliverance I entered. Before I went for my professional exams, a strong man confronted me. I know what I encountered in my first degree. So I had to, after the exams, I came for the deliverance. On April, they sent me a text from Abuja. My name was included. Just want to appreciate the name of the Lord Almighty that did it very clean and wonder for me. Because I know what I encountered before. But I just want to tell him, all what the Lord has done in my life and is about to do in my life, may his name be highly exalted forever in the name of Jesus.
She had a brain injury and she came to this place and brought me in.
I came to this place.
and the one you can sleep. I said, I want to be on local so I can sleep. I will hear what you say in the theater. They opened me up and I heard the doctor say, Kai, this is not fibroid. And other doctors were saying, what is it? Say, why would she be suffering this kind of thing at this level? It's not fibroid. So are up. They sewed me up and brought me out. That was the beginning of my pains. I wept. I had to ask God a question. Why would I go through all of this? I was married. I don't know where it came from. I suffered that pain for 1 year. You can't stand constant pains. I was on pain relieving drugs, injection. It graduated from one stage to another. From 2010, it was something else. I started working. I couldn't keep money. You know, a sick man is a dead broke man. I was living on drugs. I have to borrow money to buy drugs. I spent everything I had on drugs. The company I was working for, someone I was struggling with, I can be on pain for 48 hours, non-stop. Non-stop pain for 48 hours. It's like a labor pain. It does not, you know, respond to any drugs. If you give me, they have to power pentazocine. For some of you who are medical, in the medical field, you know how strong pentazocine is. Diclofenac, it doesn't even work with diclofenac. I am on IVF, they power this thing. 3-4 hours later, the pain gets worse. These guys look at me and say, your kidney is what we are afraid of. It will collapse your kidney with the level of painkillers we are giving you. I didn't know what to do at that point. I knew this is beyond medical. I decided to have a specialist hospital in Port Harcourt. If you don't save a life, you know that they are specialists from India. They say they are the best hand. I went. Very expensive hospital. All my salary keep going to that hospital. The doctor looked at me and said, we are going to conduct a surgery. Laparoscopy, myomectomy, we are going to do a major incision. I said, okay, what's over $11,000? I called my company and said, assist me. They said, okay, they can do it well. Again, they came up, they said, they are not sure if it's going to be successful. I became discouraged again at that point. In fact, when I went to that hospital, the case came again. They were battling in that hospital to stop blood. As they are pumping in blood, you know, giving me a blood transfusion, I'm bleeding it out. They struggle with hormonal drugs to control it. It won't stop. The pain was there. Two things at the same time. I'll be as white as this thing you're seeing here. Nobody knew how to handle it. The doctor, you know, sometimes they won't want to tell you they can't handle it. They kept managing it. I brought in people to pray for me. When they told me they can't handle it, 50-50, I decided to look for another hospital. I searched an hospital in America, Florida specifically, and I saw something, a similar thing like that. They call it titanomyosis, and I saw the incision they did. When I got the hospital, I was making plans. I told my company, I said, okay, if that's what will save your life, let's support you, you go. You know, I went into YouTube to search about this surgery. I saw 45 incisions in the womb, meaning that they're going to cut every pieces and bits of your womb into 45 places and restitch them, you know. And cutting that means they have to struggle to tie your vein so that you don't have excess bleeding during this operation. It was so difficult. Operation for 24 hours. I saw it in YouTube. I dropped my phone. I started crying. I said, I can't go. Already, I am always anemic, lack of blood. I battled to build my blood. My company asked me why. I said, no. And then I felt, I can't do medical anymore. I started looking spiritual. They took me, this girl said, ate deliverance. I lost count of mine. All the friends of men, of God, pastors, you know, the kind of pastors we have in these days, they come, they say, you're going to do the assignment, something I don't believe in. I was reduced to that point. They would take money from me. I spent close to almost $600,000 last year. Different kinds of assignment. They would say, you go to water. I said, no, I am a Christian. When it has to do with water, forget it. I can't. So to cut the long story short, I went through all of this. I pray a lot. I was asking God, where did I go wrong? Whatever I did, have mercy. If doctors can look at me and have mercy and cried, a doctor cried in the hospital and said, bless him, I feel your pain. And I said to God, I don't know where to go again, but you have to make a way for me. It was beyond me. My friend invited me to this place. I came in here. Ordinarily, I can't stay till now without food. Why? Because the drugs has caused serious gastric acidity in the system.
You don't become doctor.
You know, in the family of ulcer. So I can't stay anything beyond 11 o'clock. I'll be shaking. My tummy will swell. A lot of things. My system will turn upside down. So when I came into this place on Tuesday, that thing happened to me. I ran outside, I started shivering. My friend encouraged me. The lady I met, he said, come in, try. On Wednesday again, I almost slept. I entered my car, said, I want to go. Let me go and find a way. When it calms down, I can come back. One of your deliverance minister met me. I called my spirit with me. I said, can I take injection to kill it first? Guy said, come in here and stay. I know what I'm telling you, you'll get healed. I came into this place. Without food, I was still observing the fast. The first thing I noticed was, I didn't have that gastric pains, you know, that upset my system. I believe God. If someone that had brain injury can be healed, I knew that God was going to do something. When I saw that sign, my faith increased. I sat here again, I heard series of testimonies. How somebody came with BP, didn't take BP drugs, and the BP was as low as. I said to God, if you're truly God in this place, manifest yourself in my case. I clear into every testimony I had here. And I can tell you as I'm standing here, I stopped taking the drugs. I said, whatever is going to be, let it be. Until this second I am standing and talking to you, I'm not taking the tablets.
Are you putting your hands on the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords? Are you clapping for Jesus, people of God? You don't understand. I wish you understand. You will do it better. 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 You will do it better.
It's okay.
You will do it better.
It's okay.
Better. For the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. For Alpha Omega.
Okay.
Thank
okay.
you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. A song in our Bible. A song in our choir boom says, Abasia Yaya Nanando. My name is Blessing Edward. I have seen God so wholesome. Abasia Yaya Nanando. If you have gone through issues of life and then you have a relief, you will understand better. For people who have not experienced anything in life, this thing might not look like anything. I know what I'm talking about. I came to this place in that June, just like what you have seen. Exactly what you've heard. In that June, that pain ceased. I came back again in July. It was actually my next monthly flow. Again, I have faith. Pastor said, before you come, go and do tests. I went to the scan. They did the test. And you know, before now, I stopped going to do this. Because before they finish the results and the analysis, you can die. They will tell you things that you will not be able to collect the results. I went again. I said, ordinary, if it's me, I won't go. But since he said I should go. When the guy finished the, in fact, when he was doing the analysis, he was just shaking his head. Right there on the bed. I said, this is what I don't like. Immediately I came there, I wanted to start analyzing since it wasn't a hospital. Normally, if you go as an individual, they want to analyze. I just listened for listening's sake. My head was like this after the analysis. I said, this is why I didn't want to go. However, I took it. I told the guy, I said, if medically it's difficult, he was telling me your stomach will not be able to contain baby, to contract, to discontract, to all sorts of things. I said, okay. If he can't contract medically, spiritually, through Christ Jesus, it will contract. I left the hospital. I came to this place. In fact, my faith went cold again. You know, when you hear certain things, it has a way of demoralizing you. I came to this place. I took the report to doctor, to pastor. Again, you know the way he behaves. He didn't even take it serious. Somehow, I was like, this man can't even open the result to look at it very well. At least ask questions. Let me explain. So even when he was saying, I've seen worse case than this, keep it. I was busy explaining. I said, let me tell you how it is. So at the end of the day, he encouraged me, said he has seen worse cases. I should bring it to the altar. I brought it to the altar. I was praying. While, that deliverance session was going on. Meanwhile, since that day till even the second deliverance session, no more pains. Right here, my flow came. There's a water they gave us and it just came on that Saturday. And I was to go to Lagos on Sunday morning for an official job. Again, I ran to him. I said, sir, the thing don't come. Oh. I said, I don't know. He said, nothing will happen. Believe it. I went. Even in the aircraft, I was shivering. You know, I was so conscious of myself. Do you know that I went to Lagos? What has not happened in the past 2 years? I can't even remember. My flow just came the normal way. In fact, when I went, I had padded myself with a whole lot, all the water they gave, all the olive oil. But, you know, and I was having dreams, deliverance in the dream. I saw that someone very close to me coming back to return what belongs to me. And somebody was saying, put your hand and collect it. That is yours. That is yours. So I had a lot of deliverance even when I left this place. When I now this thing came, it started normally. I could only say a little, maybe extra day or two, and ended without any medication. And since that June till this second, I am standing and talking to you. I have never known anything called pains. Case was arrested there and then, and that was the end. And I believe that this is just the end. Again, like I said, because the demon that afflicted me blocked everywhere. I remember mentioning that I went to embassy, I was supposed to travel and all of that. And after my company had done everything, and not just like I'm traveling on my own, on behalf of a company to go and do a job, and the company over there too, a multinational company over there in the US were also waiting for me. They have even written to the American embassy. Everything was right. I got there. The consulate didn't even look at me. The lady just looked at me and said, I'm sorry. The only question she asked is, have you been to Texas? And I said, no, that's why I'm here. She just declined me visa. I didn't know what to do. Money has already been paid. You know when you're confident that this thing is going to scale through because it was a very genuine case. I got back to my hotel room. I was scared to even get to the office to tell them I couldn't get it. I was wondering, I said, God, what's happening to me? While I just closed my eyes, somebody appeared to me, said, you cannot leave this country. No matter what you try, just a very brief kind of a trance, and the person disappeared. I woke up again. I started shaking. Do you know that when I came to this place, pastor said, don't worry, bring your passport. I came here with my passport, I prayed. As I'm talking to you, while I was here, they said, come and pick your visa. Your visa is ready. So, I'm here to tell you, I can't count it. Even right in this deliverance service again, I got a great testimony. I don't want to take you all through there. But I'm here to encourage you. I don't know what the problem is. I don't know, because everything is your faith and your belief. If you can hear my testimony today, and I'm standing here to tell you, I'm not missing any word, I'm not exaggerating. I'm here to encourage you. No matter what, mostly with health issue, forget doctor's report. Try God's report, and you will see the difference. I want to say, let all glory, all honor, be ascribed to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
Praise God. I just want to bless God on behalf of my mom. My dad died 3 weeks ago, and since my dad died, I'm Mary Linda. My mom is Cecilia Nyabike. Since my dad died, my mom had been seeing him in the dream. He will see him sometimes with my grandmother that died since 5 years. My dad will not say anything. My mom, my grandmother will be very angry in the dream. She will be saying all sorts of things. Then the dream kept coming. She will tell me, I don't know what to do. We pray, but sometimes you will pray, look as if God is not answering prayers. So we'll pray and pray and pray and pray. I've known my mom, she's a very good woman. She's good. My mom is a good woman. She's not a born again like that, but she's nice. So she did not do anything to my dad that my dad would be disturbing her in the dream. So I don't know what to do. I said, somebody told us about this place. I brought her here, though she's not here today.
And since she came here, she has not been seeing the dream and my dad again. The thing has left. And I just want to bless the name of the Lord again. My mom had a problem on her leg. When we came here, the leg started swollen. She told me that this leg is disturbing her. The pain came from her leg to here. So I told her, okay, since the pastor blessed water, drink the water. She drank the water and poured the water on her leg. Instantly, the swelling came down. Her leg became normal. So I just want to thank God again. Yesterday, I took her home. On getting to my house, as I felt, I started sleep. I was not really sleeping. I was in the room. My mom was in the parlor sitting down. I was hearing my dad's voice in the parlor. She was arguing with my mom seriously. They were arguing. So I wanted to stand up from the bed to go and let me go and see what is even saying that thing. I said, how can my father be talking that he's dead? My mom, she was very strong in the spirit, unlike her. My mom is a very quiet person, but she was very strong. She was talking with my dad, talking. At the time, her voice supersede my father's voice. So she was talking. Me, I started praying from the bed. When I wanted to wake up, the thing held me down. I cannot stand up from the bed. The forces held me down. I started praying. I said, God, I came to mountain of fire. I received power here. I tarried there. Even with this baby, I fasted. So let this thing leave me. Let me stand up and leave this place. As I was saying it, I stood up from the bed. I went to the parlor. My mom was snoring and sleeping. I prayed for her, anointed her, and the thing stopped. This morning, she told me she had a dream where my father was standing from his stand and told her, bye-bye. So I just want to bless the name of God for doing that.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My name is Ezine James. I thank God for bringing me to this place. He has wrought terrible deliverances in my life. I just want to mention one. In 2008, I had a miscarriage, which then 2009, I had an ectopic pregnancy. And after that time, the doctor said there were complications, so they couldn't handle it. And since I worship in the university chapel, so we had many specialists and consultants there. I kept changing them, you know, like wrapper from one to the other till I got to the last one, who is like maybe the most senior. Then he said, don't worry, God can do anything. So by God's grace, he treated me till in 2012, I had a baby. But that 2009, there's a particular pain that developed. Usually it comes, when it comes, it's like some scissors are inside, you know, just trying to cut off pieces of something inside you. I was even surprised that with that pain, I could take it. I thought that when I had that child, maybe the pain would stop. But after I had, you know, with my baby, he's going to 5 years now, the pain had been there. So when I came here, the pain came up on that Monday. Oh, I was disturbed. I said, how can I finish this fasting with this pain now? So throughout that Monday, I was uncomfortable. I couldn't really follow. But I kept telling, you know, that pain. Now, this place is a burial ground, and I'm not going with you. So on Tuesday that I suddenly realized that the whole thing had disappeared. Till now, I did not have it again. Praise the Lord.
Shout hallelujah. Shout a bigger hallelujah. Adeniyi Alebi Osu is my name. I'm thanking God this morning for what he has done in the life of my friend. I believe some of you are here sometimes ago when I was sharing a testimony about my friend in America where his fiancée has been denied visa 4 times. So he called me. He said somebody told him that I'm a pastor now, that if there's any way I can help him. So I said, no problem. It's God that will do everything. So we started praying. To cut the story short, they gave her visa. But last 2 weeks, he called me because he went there for master's program. And he has finished. And he doesn't want to come back. So he now told me that he has applied for green card. That what is he going to do? I said, okay, no problem. So we are praying. And already they have fixed the date for the interview for him. I now gave him a prayer point. That pray that if this interview will not favor you, that they should scatter it. And he's the person that was so anxious, wanted to know the next thing. I said, you should forget about it. The most important thing is what they will give you is not where you will get it. If they reject it now, you might be finding it difficult to get it back again. So and I say, okay. He now said, okay, no problem. 2 days later, they canceled the interview. So I now told him that let's continue to pray. As we are praying, he now told I told Arun. Arun said I should give him this prayer ring. There is a place easy of passage. There is a prayer point there if you are going for an interview or anything. So thank God, because his fiancée was there and she has been attending Mountain of Fire. When she was going, I told her that she buy some books and take it along. So he started praying. Late, about 3 or 4 days later, he called me that they have fixed the date, another date, this last Wednesday. I now told him that is fine, that we are even having a deliverance program that we'll be praying together. So we started praying. And I said, if you have any dream, let me know. Second day, he told me, he said he had a dream that in that dream, he was calling his lawyer that's supposed to follow him to that interview. But the lawyer refused to pick the call. And he now went to the office. He did not see the man. He met the secretary. In that dream, the secretary now told him that there is a man that called Aoga that he should not bother himself about his case. He now said, who is the person? The person did not tell him. So another call now came in that dream. Somebody called him, his friend, and told him that there is a guy that told one lawyer about his case that he should not bother about his case. He now told the guy that, do you know the boy? He said, yes, that he will send his number. In that dream, the person now sent the number to this my friend in that dream. And he looked at the number. And the number is in his phone, but there is no name. And I now asked him, he now woke up. I now asked him, do you remember the number? He said he remembered the last 6. But the other one, I said, no problem. Continue to pray. That is no good. You should continue to pray. So he was not telling me that this thing, because he's a Catholic. But thank God, he's coming out gradually now. Because of this prayer, he now believed that where he finds himself is not the best place. So he now, after he now called me again that he had a dream that after we are praying that there is, in that dream, him and that lawyer, they went to a particular office. And when they got there, they met a man and they just discussed something with the man. And at the end of the day, the man just said, it's approved. I said, that is it. That they have approved that thing. I should just forget about it. He did not believe. He said maybe because he was thinking about it. I said, no, that God was communicating with you. That thing has been settled. So I now told him that day, if you are going on that Wednesday, that call me so that we pray together before you enter for the interview. He called me. I pray for him. We pray for some minutes. And after the prayer, he said, so Ade, you are not a pastor. I did not even know that you can pray like this. I said, just leave that one. Enter first. Immediately, he entered. My brother, my sister, they did not conduct any interview. They just, he said they were just discussing. They were just discussing. One of them now said, I don't know, the guy from Nigeria? He said, yes. In fact, before he got there, that thing has been approved. Praise the Lord. So, I want to thank God because God has not disappointed me. Amen.
Church, praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. My name is Victoria Odemejon. I'm here to give God all the praise, all the worship, adoration for what he's done in my life. During the course of this deliverance, on Monday, I came here. Pastor raised a prayer point that concerning, because I do have this attack, even I do see myself in the dream, I'll write exams, but I don't submit. Or most times I'll write the exams, I will struggle to submit. At the end, maybe the teacher or the invigilator might collect it from me, punishing me for not submitting on time. And these things always happen physically. And when it's time for exams, a week before the exams, I always fall sick. Serious heaviness in me. I won't be able to read. I won't be able to do anything. My mom will always like, you, why is this thing always happening to you? When it's time for exam, you always fall sick. She will pray for me. But I also thank God that I do pass my exams. Because when you are destined by God to be something in future and to be a shining star, the enemy see that your star is shining. No matter what they try to do to you, your star keep on shining. Praise the Lord. So that after the night session that Monday, I slept. I saw the GO, Dr. Dickie Olukoya, and our daddy, Pastor Chicks, with a man in white. They were praying to us as if it was a deliverance ground. They were praying, laying hands on people. So they got to my place. Pastor, the GO laid his hands on me, and immediately I felt an arrow. I saw an arrow leaving me immediately. So I give God all the praise and adoration for what he has done for that. Secondly, and during when he was praying for me in the dream, a demon came out of me and was like, you have tried to stop you from coming to this church, but you still refuse. You are so stubborn. The demon hissed and walked out. On Tuesday, after the night session also, on Wednesday, I had a dream. I went to the house in the morning. I had a dream. I saw one of my father's late uncle coming to me. So as if I went to the village and I saw him coming towards me. He was like, you, this girl, you are so stubborn. You and your mom, you are so stubborn. I've tried all possible ways to hinder you and your mom, but it seems you are too strong for me to handle. But the only person I can handle, I will handle with the person. I say, you can never handle anybody in my family. Uncle, you are dead and you are dead forever. The dead doesn't have anything to do with the living. So I was like challenging him in the dream. A man came out and also challenged him. Then he disappeared. I turned to my right. I saw a pear tree. So I went to that tree. I started picking the fruit. A boy was on top of the tree, was plucking down the fruit for me. I was like, senior, pick this fruit and go and give it to your mommy. The boy showed a big bag for me. I picked the fruit. I put it inside a bag. Then I turned in that same, in this compound, I turned to my left. I saw a mango tree. I sighted two beautiful ripe mangoes. So I was like, oh, this mango, I need to pluck it for my mom. A woman came and like, no, you won't pluck that mango. She was challenging me, trying to drag with me. I pushed her away. I followed her in the dream. I told her, you don't have the right. This mango is my mom. I'm going to pluck it for my mom. So I tried all possible. I said, even if I don't know how to climb a tree, I will climb this tree today by the power in the name of Jesus. I climbed the tree and I plucked the mango tree. I put it inside a bag. I went to the house. Immediately I opened the door. I called my mom. I said, mommy, take. This is for you. I woke up. And there's this pain I also have. I have this chest pain since my GS1. So I want to give God all the praise and adoration for healing me. The headache and the chest pain I always have since my GS1 has been over. I say, may his name be highly praised and exalted in the name of Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm Sister Glory Mom. I came in here with bundles of problems and affliction. I was unable to sleep for a long time unless I take some sleeping pills. So on Wednesday was the first day that I slept without taking anything. At times I would take the drug, but I could not sleep. But this day, after the prayers, when we were told to go and rest, I saw myself sleeping and wake up very sound. Praise the Lord. Another thing is that I'm so thrilled that I couldn't believe that I can stand. Since the time that we were called out to come and give testimony, I can stand to come and give this testimony. So I want to tell God, thank you so much for restoring my leg. Because Pastor said that God has seen somebody with leg pain, and I claim it, and I have seen it today. I can stand and testify. Praise the Lord. And another thing is that when praising and washing was going on, I think on Wednesday, somebody gave me two children, two male children. And I just opened my eye and said, ah, what am I going to do with these children? Praise the Lord. So after, I just called some one of us and pray and give it to her. Because, no, I'm not in need this time. Praise the Lord. So I want to tell this God, thank you very much for delivering me from every affliction that I came here with. It. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. My name is Etim from Imebon Joshua. I came here to return back all the glory to Jesus. Last month, I was feeling pains on my breast, very strong one. The sensation was too much. I can't even tell anybody what was going on. I came to this deliverance this month. On Wednesday, Pastor make a declaration that every spirit of cancer should leave your body. Me, I didn't even know that it was a symptom of cancer. But me, I was praying that any pains, that God should take it away. I didn't know. That day, on Wednesday, I felt under anointing. And since that day on Wednesday, the pain stopped. I can't even feel anything till today. Came to return back all the glory to Jesus.
Church, praise the Lord. My name is Idara Eshit. I'm here, Idara Eshit. I'm here to return all the glory to God for what God has done in my life. I want to thank him for his goodness upon my life and for the salvation of my soul. It was in July deliverance. That was my first time attending deliverance. It was after the deliverance on Saturday. The pastor said we should go home, anoint our room and our environment, and we should pray. I did the same. I anointed my room. I prayed. And immediately, I slept off. When I slept off, it was as if I was outside my room. Coming in, I saw one huge, black, tattered man standing by my table, using my cup to drink water. And I shouted. I was so surprised. I said, who are you? What are you doing with my cup? Why are you drinking with my cup? He started begging me, please, 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 please. I'm sorry. I said, who are you? Where are you coming from? He said, please, please, please. I shouted and my brothers came out. They started beating him up. I now said they should stop beating him. They should hand him over to me. They handed him over to me. I beat the hell out of the man. And I'm so grateful that I defeated that strong man that was troubling my life. Glory be to God. Amen.
Praise the Lord. My name is Scholastic Okonefio. I want to thank God for his grace and favor. For the past 2 weeks before I came here, I wouldn't be able to sleep every night. But since on Monday, the few hours they give to us to rest, I can sleep even up to now, even on Sunday, even now, on Saturday night. I can sleep. Even yesterday, I was having chest pain. So I was praying to God. I thought, God, I came here with good health. I can't go back with this kind of cold in my body and the chest pain. This morning, I couldn't feel the pains again. His name be praised.
What the devil has stolen in my life. Precisely when I was in my GS3, I started noticing that my books were just missing. So from that instant till I wrote my exam this term, my last position was second. I dropped to fifth, constant position, fifth. So as I was praying on Friday, I just saw myself in a trance. I saw a man. He came and took something from my seat and he ran away. So I pursued him and I collected it back. I did not take it as a serious note. So on Saturday, as we were praying for the anointing oil, I just felt a heat sensation on my head. When I woke up, when I opened my eye, I saw that it was turning around my head. I did not still take it serious because it was not one of my prayer requests here. So as they were now sharing their experience, a revelation just came to me that That's your brain that the enemy has stolen from you, that the Lord has restored. Secondly, I also want to thank God for taking me away from every siege of stagnation in my family. We are actually 9 in number. I am the 8th child. We are only remaining 2 to get married. Before my sisters finished their secondary school, they are already married. Before my brothers, one that struggled so hard, before he was in the university, for years, his results, the devil sat on it and he did not allow it to be released. And he had just forgotten about it like that. But as I was praying, I felt under the anointing. Immediately the pastor said, that's your family glory. That's your family star that the enemy has stolen. He will restore it. I felt under the anointing. And since that moment till now, I want to thank God that I have felt peace. Praise the Lord.
I want to thank God. My name is Evangelist Favor Odochukwu. I want to thank God who does not allow the seed of Jacob to seek him in vain. I want to thank God for what God has been doing in my family in this deliverance. I came in here on Monday. Because of what the enemy has been battling in my life, I saw myself helping people, but I cannot help myself. Each time I took in, a phone call will enter. How are you? I just want to say hi to you. I will lose the pregnancy. Enemy battle with me to an extent that they use 3 groups in the dream. If they come as an armed robber, they could not get it. They will come as a police. If they come as a police, they will not get it. They will come as an armed robber, police, and masquerade. Hallelujah. And each of these 3, they must get something from me. They keep on collecting. I mean collecting everything from me. I keep on praying and it looks like if I'm not praying. And I called my husband this week. I said, no, I think I need someone else to help me. That was how I came to this place. My mother was complaining. The same spirit transferred to my younger brother. And he was going through another battle. I said, I'm coming here. When I came here, the number started calling me. He was calling me. And he did not get me. I did not answer the call. Hallelujah. Because that didn't make me to understand that an occultic man might be in your family and he'll be using all these strategies to get things from you. So immediately I got that idea. I stopped answering the call. Praise the Lord. And my younger brother will just be in my family as an agent. He will be collecting money. Anywhere he sees it, he will use it to play coupon. He doesn't use the money to eat or to dress himself or do anything, but he's playing coupon. I told my mother, I said, give me one of his clothes. If somebody could use somebody's clothes in a cutting altar or in a native doctor and it works, give me his clothes. Let me go for prayer. Hallelujah. On Wednesday, I saw God and my younger brother. An angel gave him a soap. He was betting all those nonsense out of him. Hallelujah. I want to thank God again this morning after yesterday. Prayer. I saw myself that I was in a particular place. All the powers that was attacking me were so angry with me. And I saw the angel of God connecting all the speakers that were disconnected from the wire. I give God all the glory in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. I'm Nkechinyere. The problem that brought me to this wonderland was I had a series of problems. As a graduate for 6 years, searched for job, it wasn't coming. I now decided to switch to learn a trade. During the process of learning this trade, I saw the devil's hand front, back, center, that to even settle and to learn this thing properly was a problem, but I scaled through. But at the end of the day, I couldn't make anything out of it. I said, okay, let me settle for marriage. At least everything cannot just go like that. I made up my mind, I want to get married. A young man that I really know and I was very comfortable with, all of a sudden had interest and was coming. I said, oh, this can only be God. And we made up our mind, we went forth, and we went to the village and we started what we were supposed to do. But when we were supposed to go back and complete all the rites, I saw the devil fighting up, down, middle, center. Nothing was coming from anywhere. I was now wondering, this thing is really serious. So he just won't rubbish my life. I said, I lie. You don't fail. I now said, I must marry. Even though with or without a proper right, I was tired because nothing was working. From a family of 7, I found myself struggling. School, I managed to graduate out of school. I have a first sister
that went to school at the point of going for her NYSC, things went completely wrong. She went back home. A second sister could not even go to school. A first elder brother could not go to school. The second, my immediate brother, is through with school, but could not get his certificate. I came out to be the only one that went for NYSC and came back. It was not my making. I still know that. A younger sister, she's true, but cannot get her certificate up to date. The only last born that at least by now, with six elder ones, should be able to take care of the fees. He had a first admission on merit, but lost it because there was no money to pay the fees. He went again on merit, just the school here. A good and a wonderful chap. I came with him the last deliverance. He was here. He went to school and he was doing well. He kept telling us, you people should contribute for my school fees. I will be wondering, what is 75,000 naira that six whole young, mature people could not pay? Sometimes I wake up and I cry. I ask God, could it be you just created some people to be useless or some people should just perish in shame? I was so worried. I now told myself, if this boy doesn't go to school, it's either I stop going to church and talking about God. But something told me that is the devil trying to use you to the last. But on the long run, I saw that this boy dropped out of school. We couldn't pay his school fees. He called me up. He said, sis, I no go cry you. I will not cry because I know God has a perfect plan. I called him back. He came back home. We talked and I told him, don't worry, things will be fine. I keep having this faith that things will go right, but I just didn't know how it would come. And me personally, out of frustration, I said, nah, what wedding gown or no wedding gown, I just want to go. I want to leave my father's house. I left last year. I had a miscarriage that I didn't know how to manage. I slept, this stupid spirit spouse that I didn't even know existed from anywhere, slept with me, met with me in my dream, and I lost the baby. I did not just lose this baby. It was a whole... I stayed in the hospital for 2 weeks that my elder sister was wondering, what happened? I ran a series of tests. The doctor said, maybe it's an incompetent cervix. I was now wondering, incompetent cervix? I've never heard of a thing like that. I said, okay, let's know what caused it. They keep asking me on my hospital bed, madam, please, I want to know, do you carry any heavy thing? I said, no. In my elder sister's house, I don't need to wash clothes. There's somebody that does almost everything for me. He said, did you have a sudden hit on your tummy? I said, no. Please, I don't know. Nothing really happened. I did not have... Malnutrition, definitely, if you look at me, though I'm not big, I am not malnourished. And they didn't know what to diagnose. My elder sister and I said, what is this lady's problem? I want to know. They said, madam, like this thing is hereditary. My sister said it cannot be. My mom has 7 of us and she doesn't have such problem. Through the family line, there is no cause for miscarriage. So I didn't really know. This year, I took in again and I didn't even know. But somehow, I went to a place and I found out I was pregnant and I was so pleased with myself that God don't punish that Satan. He doesn't want anything to work. This one has worked. But along the line, I went for a scan, and for a scan, yes, because of my story, because I had to tell the doctor my past, the story I had last year. He said, madam, you need to go for this test, this test, this test. But when I got there, I was so surprised. He told me that I was growing by God's grace. When I got on the bed for the scan, the doctor said, madam, there is nothing in your womb. And he now said, one multiple rubbish. I said, that one was not my business. But I was now wondering, how come my tummy, I used to have a very perfect flat tummy. How come my tummy is just increasing and there's nothing? At that point, I was so down. My problem became so complicated. But I couldn't tell any of my, I'm one person that I know how to encourage people a lot. Even when my mom wants to be worried, I said, no worry. Maybe they're picking the high somewhere. No one makes here. I told them, I keep encouraging them, tell them, don't worry, don't worry. But I was so surprised. At the end of the day, my tummy started reducing from something to nothing. Every day when I wake up, sometimes in the morning, I'll see my menstruation. I say, this is not supposed to be a menstruation. The flow that I have never had, it comes like, and anytime it comes, the tummy goes back to the normal state. I say, God. My elder sister now came to me and I said, you need to go for deliverance in her back. I told her deliverance. Anyway, reluctantly, I woke up one morning and I was so determined. I said, I must go for this deliverance. She called me again and asked me, Chichi, are you sure you still want to go? I said, even though I will trek to that place, I will trek from Uyo to Abak. I slept 2 days later and I saw what I have never seen before. In that dream, I saw cockroach, all kinds of cockroach, big ones, the ones with wings and the ones without wings, started running out of my private part. I was so scared. I said, God have mercy. Where this thing I've been living with it, God, where did they come out from? A voice now told me, do you know where you're going to? The thing inside of you have started running out so that they will not go and disgrace them. I said, God punish them. When I came here, I don't know if some people, July deliverance, God used me in so many ways. I was just manifesting. In short, it was as if all the problem the pastor was praying about was in my family. When they talk about family problem, I'll roll from one place to another. I didn't really know what was happening to me. I keep falling, standing up. But I want to give God the glory that after the deliverance last month, I saw God mightily. Even the trade I went to learn right here, people were calling me, people I've never done anything for. They were telling me, please, oh, are they wait? I said, I'm in a program and I won't be back till Sunday. They said, no problem, we'll wait for you. I said, okay, oh, wait. When I came back, I saw God mightily walking, as in, I don't know, accuracy from nowhere just came to me. And I keep walking and I saw God financially in every aspect. Yes, please, sorry. I have a whole lot of testimonies, but at the end of the day, God did it. That is stupid spirit spouse. After the deliverance, I saw him kneeling down. Say, please, marry me. Please, marry me. I said, no, why would I marry you? I don't even know you. He said, please, that I should marry him. That the person I'm with now does not have anything. That he's very wealthy. I said, really? You're wealthy? He said, yes. He just nodded. I said, well, I don't know you, but because I'm settled already. I don't want you. And I want to give God the glory. That even at the end of the day, my mom is there. My mom always complains of knee pains. And by God's grace, her enemy has hypertension. And I know God has healed her completely. I am here to return all glory to God Almighty because he's a perfect man indeed. Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord. I want to give God all the glory for what he has done for me. By the grace of God, I am Mrs. Edna Udrak James. I had this problem right from 2011 when I got married. I lost my first baby at 6 months. And the second time was in 2013. The third one is this year. All of this problem came as a result of hypertension, something I have never thought I could have. When I told people, even the doctor would say, Madam, it's too early at your age to have this thing. I knew it was the manipulation of the devil. So this year, when the third one happened, I decided that I am living here in Abak, and I know they have been doing deliverance in this church. I encouraged myself that I will come. My husband tried to stop me because of my health. He said, you just gave birth. You won't be able to fast. I pray to God, if this man is going to stop me, just if you really want me to go to this deliverance, just make a way for me to go. Fortunately for me, he left the house that evening, on Sunday evening, and told me, I'm going to watch football. Later I will go to a friend's place. I said, God, you have done it. I make sure I tidy everything in the house. I pack my things, put in the bag. I wrote a note and keep for him. I told him, please, don't say I'm disobeying you. It may be this is, you said I've tried for 3 good times. It couldn't work. I want God to help me out. And I left the house. I came here that night on Sunday. We prayed. And later on, he called me. I said, you left the house. You don't want me to see you. I said, you were like stopping me from going to this program. And he said, okay, good night. I stayed here Monday. I started feeling that even when we were giving less hours to sleep, I slept very well. Formerly, my heart would be beating up and down. I would not have rest. It would be vibrating through my ears. And I said, God, I know this is not normal. And I want this sickness of hypertension right from 2013 to stop in this program. And God has been manifesting himself. To him alone be all the glory in Jesus' name. And secondly, I had this waist pain. When it was time for us to praise God, and I love praising God, when I want to dance and bend down, I would feel very difficult to bend. Just yesterday, we were dancing. I went there to stand because of the fasting. I was experiencing heat. So I went to stand by the fan side. And I was dancing and bending. I couldn't feel that pain again. I said to God be the glory in Jesus' name. When the people when pastor called for women that were looking for the fruit of the womb, I was among them that stood up. And pastor just looked at me and said, "Madam, your case is settled." I was looking at him like this. He said, "You don't believe?" I said, "Pastor, I believe. I know I am delivered in this deliverance meeting. And I know my deliverance is permanent. My healing is permanent in Jesus' name."
Praise the Lord. My name is Otto Obasi David. I just want to thank God for healing me of a very severe headache I had. This headache started on Tuesday when I was preparing to come. At the point, my head was turning me. It was as if my breath would cease. And sometimes a doctor reported to me that I have low BP. When the BP is normal today, tomorrow it will fall again. So when I had these symptoms, I was contemplating on how I would be able to make it in this fasting and prayer and fasting. And I noticed it is the trick of the enemy and say I must attend this deliverance service. So as I came in here on Tuesday, I did not even know how the whole thing ceased. I was okay. Praise the Lord. I just want to thank God once again. On Tuesday evening service, when the man of God was praying for us, our daddy, he was mentioning, he pronounced that every demon on the west, every demon on, he was mentioning parts of the body like that. So when he mentioned west, I fell under anointing because I had serious, I used to have serious waist pain. And this thing, when I sleep on the floor like this, the thing will increase. The thing has been disturbing me from time to time. So that day, God used the man of God and healed me. And today, throughout this service, I slept on the floor. I did not feel the waist pain again. So I want to return all the glory unto God for healing me in Jesus' name.
Church, praise the Lord. My name is MM David. First of all, I want to thank God for giving me the grace to go through these 7 days fasting and prayers. Before I came in here, I had a health challenge of which I wouldn't have been able to fast, but I just decided to calm down. Now my testimony goes, what really brought me, I came in here last year's April deliverance. I now left. I've been having the issue of a spiritual husband. And ever since, I never knew. This thing had been there for more than 20 years now. But I never knew. I was in Lagos. It was when I now came down to Akwa Ibom that people now told me, this is the problem that this thing carries. And really, it has really affected my marital life. So I came in here that last year's April. I now left. I saw some improvement. I now decided to come back this year and I must marry by fire. So when I came, I prayed and I left. When I got home on that Sunday, on Monday night, I had an encounter as if I was in a vehicle. The vehicle was just moving. Before you know it, a creature just jumped inside the vehicle and now held my hand, wanted to take my hand into his mouth to bite. I now shouted. When I shouted Jesus, immediately I saw Pastor Chooks in that bus at the back. That one shouted fire, and that creature jumped out. Then 2 days after, my elder sister called me. She said that she had a dream, and this dream has occurred for 2 times. I said, "What's the dream?" She now told me the dream that somebody confronted her. He said, "Your sister has taken me to the court to divorce me. That he was going to deal with me."
I just told my sister that I'm just from a program, that she should not bother. Then a week later again, I was sleeping around that kind after two. I now had an encounter as a man. I was in a church. A man just came in, huge. He now came with a knife. He said, "I need your blood." I said, "You cannot take my blood. Who are you?" So we now started dragging. I now dragged. Then the knife now cut my hand. I now woke up. I prayed. Then thirdly, when I slept. So thirdly, when I now slept in a revelation, I saw a snake came out of my private part. I now knew that I was delivered. So this being appeared again. When he appeared, he was just looking at me. He said, "You, go, I don't want you again. You are so ugly." So I just came to give God the glory that I have been delivered in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I want to testify the goodness of God in my life. My name is Evangelist Mabon. So on Monday, I came to this program. In the evening, as I finished the program, I lay down. God gave me vision. And my family stand and challenged me. Want to do a bad thing, you cannot do. I see the man of God stand with me. They challenge them. Don't ignore, allow them to talk again. Then on Friday, after we have finished our program, I lie down. Then I see myself as I give people drug in the dream. Then after that, in the morning, as I wake up, I have a problem in my body. That problem stays in my body as a stone. The time I go to hospital, the doctor told me it's fibro. I reject. He said, "Not fibro." But I come in here. Then I see the hand of God. As I give all that oil to drink on that Friday, I drink though, I go and shoot 6 times. I see the hand of God. God remove that thing from my belly, because sometimes you see me, my belly is swelling like this. So God touched me and deliver me. I give all glory in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. My testimony goes like this. Okay, Chidema Samuel. So it was 2003 when the Lord made me to understand that the dark hour of my life has come. And actually, it was a dark hour because everything turned around negatively. And I began to experience hardship and problems from one level to the other, one level to the other, one level to the other. And I was praying, and I was fasting, and I was even equally doing deliverances. But it grows, and it grows, until it seems the enemy has done his worst. Before then, God could come in. So Monday, when I came to this very place with my sister, since that Monday that we've been going to deliverances, I have seen the hand of the Lord upon my life. And the Lord had turned that affliction, since he showed me since 2003, he had turned that affliction for good. He had turned my sorrow into joy. I can see the hand of the Lord writing my destiny and my story. So I thank God who is perfecting this deliverance and who has taken away my afflictions. May his name alone be glorified in Jesus' name.
Dara Iumorin, I want to thank God for the privilege to stand here and testify of his goodness upon my life. And I got to know about this program through a sister-in-law. After coming for deliverance, she brought the DVD, the tape she bought. And I found time to go through it. I was watching and watching. I saw God's handwork, what God has been using Pastor Cheeks to do. Then I decided to join this time. Despite the tricks of the enemy to prevent me from coming. But I thank God I found myself. That was yesterday after when we took the oil for purging. And we were praying.
Pastor mentioned so many afflictions, and I remembered he said something about asthma, and it was like in a trance. I saw someone fell off, that someone came out from me. I didn't fall under the anointing. Something fell off, and I opened my eyes, and I was also praying and praying. God delivered me. But when I got home, I have never been diagnosed of, and I've never had asthma all my life. But when, in 2014, when I was pregnant, about 4 months pregnant of my baby, I realized I was yearning for breath. I was yearning for breath to the extent I could not walk. They rushed me down to the hospital, and the doctor said this is a sign of asthma. I rejected it there. I was so mad at him. He asked me to leave his office, and he called my husband in and was talking with my husband. At the tail end, they gave him some medication, and we left home. After that, I've not had that attack. Yesterday, I started yearning for breath like never before. I could not stand, I could not sit, I could not lie. The only thing I know I could do was to kneel down and rest my hand on something so that I could breathe. I was just doing this, I could not. But I managed to crawl to where my bag was, and I took another cup of oil. And after the order of Pastor Chiefs, I shouted 21 fire. I was shouting fire, fire, fire. And to cut the whole long story short, God restored me. Now I can stand on it. Secondly, I came in here battered and beaten. Why did I come in for this deliverance? It's because of my elder brother. He has been an issue of concern to my family, sending a son through university, and he comes back. His life is, in fact, not something we could talk about here. And I was praying for him. I said, God, I will come for this deliverance. The same way I saw people testifying on that DVD, that you will turn around his situation for good. Though I have not called them, though I have not gotten any revelation, I know that the same God that delivered me has also extended to him in Jesus' name.
Church, praise the Lord. My name is Udemi Mejosef. I'm here to thank God in two ways. I'm here to thank God for seeing me through the academic embargo that was placed upon my life. And also, I'm here to thank God for healing me. I was the kind of person, I teach others to pass. I teach people to pass WAEC. I teach people to pass JAMB. But in my own case, when I write, if my course demanded for 200, I will end up scoring 190. If I go low to the one that would demand 180, I will score 170. I say, what is wrong? Okay, let me forget about that one. I say, okay, let me forget about thing education. Let me look for something else and do. So at the point, I came to church. When I came in contact with Mountain of Fire, I said, okay, let me try. After 6 attempts, I couldn't make it. The last one, when I came to Mountain of Fire, I was able to secure 5 C's and 1 B and 1 A. I came and testified after 5 years' time. So when I applied, and the grade they demanded of me was A and B in my course. So I said, okay, I took another one this year, but I'm here to glorify God. I've made it with 2 A's, 3 B's, and 4 C's. I'm here to give God all the glory. And also, I want to thank God for healing me. When I was at home, Pastor called me. I came and I met Ifeanyi. Ifeanyi called me, said, Pastor, I want to see me. I said, Pastor, I want to see me for what? He said, Pastor, I want to see me. Pastor, I have something to tell me. So when I went to his office, he told me he had a bad revelation about me. He said, so when I went blind, my enemies went blind. I said, Pastor, what you are saying is reality. I had a dream of it long time ago. So when he instructed me to come and join Deliverance, I would plan. I arranged everything. I would say, okay, on Sunday, I would make up my mind and say, on Monday, I will be here. But when you get to that Monday, I don't even know what come over me. I would just zero my mind and say, forget about Deliverance. Let me just do normal fasting. that deliverance is too much. I will just get something and eat and forget about it. So he got to a point. My mom called me and said he had a bad dream about me. That I went to set fire on the stove and the stove exploded and the thing went into my eyes. I said, my brother called again. I said that he had the same revelation. I also have a dream and I confirmed it. I said, this thing is too much. I decided to run to deliverance. So when I came to deliverance, we was praying. We were praying. So when our Jesus said we should smash our anywhere you have pains. Meanwhile, before then I started observing water started coming from my eyes. If I'm going on bike, water will be running out of my eyes, and I also observe slight pain in this right side of my eyes. I say this is very serious, it's true. But thank God, to God be the glory, I have been healed. The pains are no more there. I'm okay. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. Praise Master Jesus. I want to testify to the goodness of the Lord, for his mighty hand of deliverance upon me. I'm Onuche Angela Iye. No long story. I'm not even ready for it. I want to thank God that his mighty hand of deliverance met me on this mountain. And I also want to give him the glory for healing me of ulcer of 8 years. I was able to go through this program without feeling the pain. And I also want to thank God for breaking the hereditary chain of hypertension in me. It has already occurred in me, and the fear was in me. I even had to talk to the pastor last night. My heart started beating. The palpitation was much last night. Heat all over. I went outside and was pouring water on my head. I didn't pour water all this time. We were doing dry fasting. But last night was much. But to the glory of God, I'm here to testify. The Lord is good. Church, join me to say thank you, Jesus.
Church, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. I am Ephraim Abonite. I just want to thank God this morning for his faithfulness over my life and family. And a special I've been requesting from God. And I know he has done that. I said, his name be praised in Jesus' mighty name. Secondly, I want to thank God for this August deliverance. He has been very special to me. I've been suffering from, I have problems as active as I am. I know that when I sleep, I'm equally active over the other side. But when I wake up in the morning, I will try to remember what I dreamt, but I will not remember anything. And so I was there on Friday when they were giving lectures on dream. And they said that if you dream and in the morning you get up, and then you don't remember anything, that it is an attack. And so I knew that was certainly an attack. I was very serious and sad within my spirit. And I said, God, please, you've been blessing others. I equally want you to bless me. And I thank God because on Friday, when I slept, in fact, God gave me a special revelation where he took me to my home and I saw some strong people in our family. And within that period, one of my cousins, just woke up and said, congratulations, that you have been given a special promotion. And in that promotion, they will give you a lot of things. And I just want to thank God because I know my promotion is permanent. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm Victoria Emmanuel. I want to thank God for what God has done in my life. When I came in, normally at home, I don't used to sleep at night. I find it difficult to sleep. When once we finish our night prayers, and when they put off the chain, I will not be able to sleep. Whenever I close my eye, I'll be seeing snake. I'll be forced to get up, untouch light and keep if I'll be able to sleep. But since I came in to this church, since on Monday, till today, if I want to sleep, I will sleep very well. I just want to give God the glory on that. Secondly, On Wednesday, I set my alarm by 5:30 so that I can wake up and have my bath. The alarm called me 5:30 a.m. I woke up and off the light, the alarm and sleep again. When I sleep between the hour of 5:30 and 6 o'clock, I had a dream. On that dream, I delivered three plates. The first one was a girl, the second one was a boy, and the third one was a girl. During the delivery period, it was only 5 minutes. I thought the normal safe delivery. So yesterday, after the morning session, I went out, I took fruit. I came into my bed, I lied there, I didn't sleep. I had a very severe pain in the ankle of my leg. I couldn't drag my leg to myself. I now roll, oh my God, who will I tell, what will I do, what is happening to me in the church? God help me. As I was talking to myself, a voice came to me that the pastor said that there will be a time that will be only you and your oil. I now remember I rolled to my box. I bring out the oil, I opened the oil, put on my palm. I didn't even say a word. I rub on that ear, the pain just disappeared instantly. I now stood up. I went to my colleague to testify what has happened, the encounter I had. When we were gisting, I told her, since that I came on Monday, I have not gone to the toilet because I've not eaten any solid thing. It's only fruit and water that have been taken from Monday. So, when we were talking, and I told her, Adam, my tummy is disturbing me. Let me rush to the toilet. My tummy is disturbing me. I went and picked my tissue. I went to the toilet. I paused. After pulling, I was about getting up. My tummy disturbed again. In fact, what I put, a very big stone. This stone that has blocked my tummy for the past 8 years. I couldn't take it. I couldn't do anything. The stone blocked me for the past 8 years. I saw God in glory yesterday for removing that stone. I say, may his name be exalted, because as I'm going as a pregnant woman that would deliver April 2017. May his name be highly exalted in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. I am Sister Sabbath. I just want to glorify the name of the Lord. Because the enemy thought he was going to make me to cry again. I said, I will not cry. He has been wanted to attack my son in various forms. God has shown me many, many times. For the past 2 weeks, even my son himself, he would dream, see him himself, people snatching him. I saw my son falling inside the pit, and I was standing crying. I cried till I woke up. I saw them, like they were attacking him here and there. They said, no, this deliverance, I must come. I thank God because on yesterday, I decided to come and sleep here in the church. Right there where I was sleeping, I saw God giving me victory over that my son. Bringing him back from where they put him, a dream that I had over 2 weeks ago, I saw God removing him from that dark pit. I saw God fighting for my children. The enemy said that they will not live to, that I will not live to see them. I saw God telling me, you will live to testify the goodness of the Lord. You will live to enjoy the fruits of your labor. I said, the Lord who has done this, may his name be glorified in Jesus' name. I also want to thank God. After we went back yesterday, I decided to sleep in that morning. As I went back, I received a good phone call. A call that will change my children's story. A call that will make my children to go to where they will have, go, where they have wanted to be. I said, the Lord who has done this, may his name alone be glorified in Jesus' name.
People of God, praise the Lord. I'm Eponimo King by name. It's so good to be home. And also, it's so good to be hearing all this testimony. And most of the times, I watch it online on YouTube. Like the video, the audio that was playing before about the sister that was testifying of different sickness. I've been watching it with my friends in China. That is where I study. And it's so good to see. We are still praying for our daddy in the Lord here to also bring the same deliverance to our church there. Because we are in a missionary church, not in deliverance church. Amen. I want to thank God for what God is doing. I have a lot of testimony, but because of time, I will cut it short. Since I traveled to China for my studies there, before traveling, I met our daddy in the Lord for him to for prayer for me to succeed academically. People of God, I arrived there 2 months after I meet the semester in the middle of this. I meet them in the middle of the semester. But to God be the glory, after the end of the semester, I was awarded with the award of excellence by the university. Amen. All this started, when I arrived, there was a revelation I had about fruit, a lot of fruit. I was just plucking fruit. I called our daddy in the Lord. I told him, sir, this is what I saw. And there was another group that was coming up, evangelism in, they call it bar ministry, creating a bar ministry, people to go to the club, the nightclub and the bar to preach the gospel. So when I talked to him about the dream and the revelation I had, he said I should take the ministry serious, that is where my blessing will come. And people of God, to God be the glory, since I took up that ministry, God has been blessing me throughout my stays there in China. I've been having favor here and there. But for the past 2 weeks, myself and my friends, about nine of us, we set out for a missionary trip to Benin Republic and Togo. People of God, God has been faithful. Before we left China, because the background of where we were coming from is a missionary church. They don't know much about deliverance, about the fetish things we are having here in Africa. So the people, my team members, were scared. So what I did was, I talked to our daddy in the Lord. I said, sir, this is where we are going. And Togo is a place, most of those places, they don't have Christianity there. They don't have church. So by the time I talked to him, he prayed for us. We left. But to God be the... Okay, when we arrived, we had a lot of challenges. But God has been so faithful. We're moving from different regions. It got to a point, a native doctor will come out to challenge us. We are just students. So, but to God be the glory, the wife of the native doctor even accepted Jesus. We preach, we minister Jesus to everybody in Benin Republic and in Togo. The son of the native doctor that was already marked for sacrifice in the shrine, God delivered him that day. God delivered the wife, and a lot of people came to burn their charms. So God did mightily work there, and we were able to plant churches. Amen. We were able to plant churches, and by the grace of God, more than 200 people received Jesus that day. Amen. Finally, we left. We came back to Nigeria. God granted us favor. My team members, they have gone back. And I came here to say hello to everybody. Thank you so much.
Praise the Lord. My name is Aniema Okpongete. I want to thank God for what God has done for me this year. Since January this year, the arrow of death has been troubling my home. But I want to thank God for mountain of fire. And I want to thank God for our pastor. I so much loved him because anytime I am in danger in the spiritual realm, he will appear. God will use his face and appear and deliver me. Whenever the death came, especially attacking my husband then, there was once he was dead in the dream. It was as if pastor was in my apartment. I rushed him to pastor's room. Pastor just woke up and saw him. He now said, Mr. Okpongete, I made covenant with God that I will not bury in mountain of fire back. So I will never start with you. And he woke up and prayed. And the arrow went back. The climax of the arrow was this Tuesday. On Tuesday evening, the arrow of death struck three of my children. At the same time, I have never seen such attack before. You run to this one, you touch this one, you carry this one. But to the glory of God, God delivered them all. I want to thank God, my first daughter that was really attacked. I was driving one hand and was carrying her one hand. When the attack was so serious in the coven, she now shouted, "Mommy, Pastor Chooks has appeared. Pastor Chooks is fighting for me. He has killed them. Praise the Lord." And because of this angel that appeared in the coven, they couldn't slaughter my daughter. And to the glory of God, my daughter was shouting the strong man that donated her. She was calling the name. She wants to cut my neck. She wants to, oh God, you are wonderful. I brought her to the church. And thank God, pastor did not enter the church. I laid him down at the feet of my pastor. And pastor delivered her. Glory be to God in the highest, forever and ever. He is a stronghold in time of trouble. May his name be glorified forever and ever. In Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. I'm Emmanuel Idio. Brethren, I thank God for giving me the grace to participate in this deliverance program. Actually, I've been planning to attend deliverance. I will plan and fail. I will keep on postponing. But something happened last week, Saturday. My niece came in from Lagos. So she arrived late in the night. And I was to go and pick her from Ikorekbene. So I drove safely to Ikorekbene. I'm coming back. By the time I got to Afarabo, a dog just ran into the road. Before I knew it, I hit the dog and dragged the dog along the road. The dog was just screaming. I parked the car by the side of the road, thinking maybe the dog will come out. So on a second thought, I felt maybe I could go out and maybe try to rescue the dog. My spirit warned me not to try it. And if I should try, the dog would bite me mercilessly. Do I even know if it was an evil dog? So I heard some boys at the other side of the road shouting, "Stop there, stop there." I quickly moved the car. In the process, I crushed the dog. So by the time I was driving, I then had a flashback to my childhood days. There was this belief we used to have when we were young, that if somebody knocks down a dog on the road, you will soon kill a human being. So the thought came, I said, no, it's a lie. Throughout the night of Saturday, I was battling within this thought between, I said, no. So I said, okay, deliverance is starting on Monday. After all, the children are on holiday. What am I? What will stop me from participating in the deliverance? So I took part. So I just saw that as God dragging me to participate. And when I came, God attended to my case. Brethren, I've been really suffering under the spell of witchcraft. This power has really disturbed me for many years. I graduated from university 19 years ago. From then till now, in terms of wealth, I'm nowhere to be found. My mates are ahead of me. Each time I used to cry within me and say, what's really happening? What's really happening? Academically, I wasn't bad. I'm not boasting. I was very intelligent in my school days. But coming out, my life is just upside down. I struggle to do everything. Everything is just full of struggling. I have keep on having dreams of going back to my former school, even after prayers. At times I used to get discouraged. I said, does it mean God doesn't answer my prayer? What is the meaning of all this? At times I get confused. The greatest challenge happened in my work at my workplace this year. Just this January, I was posted to one government farm as a farm manager. I was happy. I said, maybe this is how God wants to restore what I've lost in the past. So by the time I got my posting letter, I went to my director. He told me point blank. He said, well, I'm posting you to, there's no money in the department now. So just go and manage the place anyhow. Don't expect money from the department. I was just looking at him. He said, somebody handed over to you. So make sure that place does not close down in your own time. I went. I said, okay. By the time I went, I started work. I went back to him. I reported that a water pump that I used to pump water is faulty. Say, go and fix it. I was just looking at the man. So by the time I worked that first month, I generated some revenue. I plowed back the money into the farm. I now stated in the monthly report. The following day, I got a call from my superior officer at the headquarters that I should come immediately. I said, what is really happening? If you don't tell me what is wrong, I won't come. You can't just force me to come like that. He said, it has to do with the report you submitted yesterday. Come, the director wants to see you. So by the time I got to the director's office, he called my name 3 times. The report was still on his table. He said, look at this. Who gave you the authority to generate government revenue and now use it for your private use? I said, sir, what do you mean? When I was put, I said, I don't want any statement. Go and bring that money immediately. Pay it to the cashier. If you don't do it, I will write a letter to the permanent secretary now, and you see what's going to happen. I was just looking at him. I said, sir, I will talk. When I was posted there, how much was given to me by the department? Does it mean I will use the money I will use in taking care of myself and my family to run government project? And how do I get my money back? He said, that's none of his business. All he knows is that I should keep that place running. If I like, let me go and close down the place and we'll see what's going to happen. I was just looking at him. I walk out of the office. Say, I told him, as of this money, I've spent it. I won't pay it now. Maybe let it be at the end of the month. I left. I made up my mind I was not going to pay any money. So I told other people, they said I should report him to the permanent secretary or the commissioner. On a second thought, I decided not to report him to anybody. But I kept on praying to God. Say, God, do something in this situation. So the thing from January till now, I've just been battling like that. And each time I wake up in the morning, and I know it's a working day, I will feel sad. I will just be wondering, what kind of thing? My predecessor that was there for 8 years, she made a lot of money from that place, did a lot of things, and even saw in the monthly report how she used to generate revenue, use it, nothing was happening. Then why is my own situation different? So I was just wondering, but thank God for this deliverance, that God visited my case, and I felt the power of God, and God has really delivered me. And even pastor said that the door that was shut against somebody has been opened, and I felt the power of God. So I give God the glory because I know God has destined me for greatness. But the witchcraft parts of my father's house does not want it to be. But this God that I believe in will definitely take me to my destination. I say may his name be glorified in Jesus' name.
Praise the living God. My name is Samuel Udo. I was sick for the past 3 months. The enemy inflicted me with a deadly disease in which I could not understand. But it so happened that that time I rushed to the university teaching hospital here, and I've been there for two or three weeks. And the powers that followed me to the general hospital in such a way that I was having heart problem. But the doctors were treating asthma, and the problem got worse. And my friend later told me that I should come. He would take me to a private hospital. And then I went to the private hospital. I stayed there for 1 week. After 1 week, they discharged me and asked me to be coming for treatment after 2 weeks or thereabout. And I did. At the end, the physician that checked on me now decided that this problem he cannot handle, that he will now refer me a referral letter. To the teaching hospital, to a consultant, a cardiologist. So I went. I want to say that over there, they also get into diagnosis. I have the chest x-ray here, and they say heart failure. So right there in the hospital. So they told me that they gave me some drugs and give me a series of tests to be conducted, and that the drugs they are giving me now, it is to sustain me until I finish the test before they will now know the actual one they will give me to arrest the situation. So it was during this process. I'm from Abak Region, so the pastor was there sometime. I have been thinking all about, I said I want to come and know this place, but it wasn't possible for me. I didn't really know what happened, but it was last Sunday on the 7th of August, I was here. It was there and then that I heard about this deliverance. So after the service, I said, let me meet the pastor. I met him. Now I told him, this is my problem. He said, that problem, when he was praying, that he mentioned the problem, that the problem is gone. But when I reached home that day, you know, they gave me these drugs to be taken. So I just, when I finished eating, I thought within myself, what am I going to do now? Do I suspend this drug or I'll take it? One man said, if you don't take this drug, because I have to be taking these drugs every day. So if you don't take it, how will you sleep? How will you, you don't know what will happen next. So on that Sunday, I took that drug. But to God's glory, when I came here on Monday and started this deliverance, from that day, I ceased to take those drugs. And to God's glory, up till today, I have not taken those drugs. And I want to say that the experience I've been having, you know, somebody, they said, either the left ventricle is not pumping blood to my system, you have developed edema on my leg, on my feet. So, and I cannot move easily. If I move, I stop there, my chest will be congested. So right from that day, Monday, I ceased to take those drugs. And I want to say that I am strong. I can move. I thank God of this commission. And I give God the glory in Jesus' name.
People of God, praise the Lord. My name is Mfon Otu. I came here on Monday for deliverance service. A friend of mine in Lagos told me about. Okay, she's not even my friend. I don't know her. But I was in my friend's house and she's my friend's cousin. So she was telling me about Mountain of Fire in her back. So I told her, when I go back to you, I'm going to go for the program. She was the one that sent me the text message about the program. So on Monday morning when I woke up, I had a dream. I saw a man of God that I know sending some of his boys, and he gave them penknife to attack me. And they said, anytime I come to church, they will use it to stab me. So I overheard it and I said, I'm not going there. I'm not going there. When I slept again, I had another dream, same thing. So when I woke up in the morning, I was like, what's going on? So my friend now came to the house that morning that she's here. I told her the dream and I told her, okay, since you're here, let's go. So when we came here on Monday, I was in the church. I was sitting somewhere there. The man of God started praying for us. And he said, if there's any disease that the enemy has put in you, the sickness, that he commanded me to leave. I was there. I didn't know what happened. But all of a sudden, I heard him saying, vomit it out. All of a sudden, I don't know what happened. But when I woke up from that deliverance, I noticed I had saliva all around. I had to go get something to clean it up. On Tuesday, I was here during deliverance. God used the man of God to deliver me. It was on 2012. I had a project. My mother died when I was small. So the house she was building, she didn't roof it. It was incomplete. So I had money 2012. I decided to go renovate the house, do everything, complete that project. I completed the project. I invited somebody to come and do the borehole. They did the borehole. 3 days after that completion of all everything done in the house, I felt very sick. That I went to the hospital. All of a sudden, my body, as in the way I looked pale, I was very lean. The fat person I was very lean. So the doctor, they did series of tests on me, all to find out that I had a blood sugar. So the doctor told me that my sugar is very high, that I have to go on insulin, that my blood sugar is 14 point something at my age. Why am I supposed to have it? And it's 14 and it's too high. So I started going on insulin, 2012, take medication. all of a sudden. And when you have blood sugar, you'll be running tests every week. So anytime I run the test, it's either I'm having, after the insulin, I had 12 point something. Then when he, at the point, I had 10 point something. I know the highest I've had, that's when I go through dieting, is 8 points. So when I was there, the man of God said that during deliverance that I said so many things and I mentioned blood sugar. So he said he would love me to go and do the test. So I had to go and do the test. I've never had 6 points before.
Clapping for Jesus. Are you clapping for Jesus? So, my sister, you have done... Where is one of the doctors? Come and analyze this thing for us. End of the doctor should come and look at this so that we can confirm. Where are they now? Which doctor? Which doctor is it? Come now, guy. Doctor. Which doctor is there? Doctor, SN no go come out. The height come here. You come out. Down.
Hallelujah. Did you do the fasting blood sugar?
Fasting blood sugar. Okay. Amen. Doctor, don't answer. I don't know that one. And I hear that one again. Fasting blood sugar.
We usually do fasting blood sugar or random blood sugar.
Okay.
A fasting blood sugar will be the one in which you fast. Probably you stop eating or drinking anything by about 9 or so in the evening.
Okay.
And then you do the blood sugar before 9 a.m. That means you would have fasted from food and drink for at least about 12 hours or thereabouts. Then you do that blood sugar. And the normal, like it's written here, is supposed to be between 3.5 to 5.5. For a fasting blood sugar. If it is a random blood sugar, that means you just stand up anytime like all of us here and you had eaten and you just do it. That one, the upper limit should be about 7.5. So but what she has now is 6.8 millimole, which is very close to the upper limit of normal.
So it's...
So she... Yes, it's very close to the upper. But if it was a random, this would be a normal blood sugar.
Okay. Normal blood sugar. If it is random, it will have been normal.
Yes, if it is random, this is a normal blood sugar for random.
But what do you normally have before? 12 points.
10 points.
Before?
Yeah. And
okay, all, when you were doing dieting, managing
and,
the...
And all of them were... fasting.
So this one now.
Yes, this one is okay.
Very correct. Yes. From, can we appreciate Jesus? Amen. I told her, go and do the test. Come with it so that we can. Because I know that when the demon behind the affliction has been arrested, automatically everything will reverse back to normal. Now, do you know how many years this man has been battling with this thing now? You went to your village to do. Is it a bad thing for somebody to do good thing in the village? Where did you go to do it?
In my mother's house. My mother bought a land, not in the village.
Not in the village.
Because I don't go to the village.
You don't go to the village. Where did you do the project?
At the Doro Road.
At the Doro Road.
Yes.
But that was where the affliction came from because the woman, the thing said, hear me. Now, one thing is that I don't know. Many times, it's not every time you must let people know the good thing you want to do. I'm talking to somebody now. Because that you want to do might be the source of the battle. Why? They might say, nobody have done this before here. What are you trying to tell us? So you want to come here and change the story and tell us that you are the head. And before you know, the battle will become so strong. But in this case, what afflicted her was a family spirit called a Ekpenyo deity. And her grandmother said her grandmother took her from somewhere to somewhere when she was born and all that. Now she can't marry. She tries to run away, but she can't. I have infected her with sickness and I gave her blood sugar and bad luck. That was when I asked her, do you have sugar problem? She said yes. Because the demon made mention of it. And when the demon says it, it's like that. Because that is what the demon introduced into her life to cause problem for her. So that she can waste her money. So that she can spend money. Do you know what dieting means? That you can't eat like every other person. You can't do this other people are doing. And you have to be managing yourself. Managing yourself. Meanwhile, it's not natural. It's a spirit that is behind it. I am praying for somebody. The God that delivered this sister is alive. So it's not that we say, wait, put your hand down first. You like prayer. Amen. Listen carefully. You know me now. You are getting used to me. Amen. You are getting used to me there. Listen carefully. I said it earlier. When you have any problem medically, please go for deliverance first. No matter how big the report is, come for deliverance. Then, after deliverance, check yourself and see if it's not, if you find a change or you have a revelation toward it, come back again. Then check again. From there, if after about 4 or 5 times it remains, then you know that you have to look for sick medically. Am I talking to somebody there? But whether it is orchestrated by actual wickedness or natural, God can still heal it. Depending on your faith, that's where faith comes in. Because at times, God might have done it, but you still be feeling. You heard what that man said. It was on Sunday. Every Sunday, present deliverance is our pre-deliverance service. After drinking the water, he came to me and I said, the Lord told me that he has healed somebody of a heart condition. I said it by the grace of God, by his power, not by my power. That he has healed somebody of a heart condition issue. So when he came to me, you know what I said? But you heard the word that came forth, that he has healed you. So have faith and go. But he said the fear, when he got to me, he had to take the drug. Amen. And listen carefully. Anything that is happening here, I don't know, we've not met this sister before. We don't know her anywhere. She came, she had somebody sharing the testimony of her back in Lagos. She heard. And she said, I want to come there. And she came. And when God did it for her, and I said, go back, conduct the test. Come. I didn't know she had the test. But I knew she was not sad. I was one that told pastor to tell her to come out because she didn't write on the testimony form. I said, that sister that was delivered, ask her to come out and testify, because if you don't testify, it can lead to doubt. I never know that. And when doubt is a play, the demon can come back again. That is why when God do something for you, if you have the privilege now, when we go to the deliverance, please raise up your hands. Or any other Sunday you have chance, come to this place, testify here, and then go back to your church. And I thank God for what God is doing here. And listen carefully, whatever you see is real. It's not make up, it's not mark up, it's direct from El Shaddai. Am I talking to somebody here? Somebody shout a better hallelujah. Sister, are you true? Okay, fire.
People of God, the devil is a liar. He tried to challenge me, and I told him that the man of God said we are stronger than him. When I was during deliverance on Tuesday, I fall under deliverance. I went outside to pick something in my car before then.
Under anointing?
No, before the anointing.
Okay, before the anointing.
Yes. So, I didn't know I forgot my car key inside my car. Just outside my car. So, when church dismissed, I checked my back. I didn't see my car key. So, I wanted to look for my car key. Then, that's when the man of God that always was doing registration there came to me. I saw him standing. He called me. And he said I should call my friend. I called my friend. He said that somebody was passing by the road. The person had to park his car and walk into the car and remove my car key and give it to him. That I would have put the church into big trouble by losing my car. That the only thing he knows that when I came, he noticed that I was the one driving the car. So he knows the car is my car. So I collected the key. I thanked him. I told him I've never had such experience. That the only mistake I could make is leaving the car without locking the car. But as for the key, I'm always with my car key.
So yes.
On Friday, when I was coming to church in the morning, when I was driving down, I serviced my car 3 weeks before now. So on Monday when I was coming, I checked the oil very well. So on Friday, when I was coming to church, I was just driving. My car was sounding very well. No, I didn't have any issues. The next moment, I heard a sound.
So I decided to let me park and check what sound is that. When I parked the car, I tried to start the car, I couldn't start. And I left the car, I called my mechanic to come and pick the car. So later my mechanic called me in the evening after service. I saw his missed call, I had to call him. And I asked him, what happened? He said, my car has really suffered him, that the engine has knocked. I laughed. I told my friend before now that I'm suspecting I'm having a knock engine, that's a knocking sound. But should I cry or should I laugh? I told her I am laughing because the devil is a liar. So that same Friday evening, when I was in the kitchen to get water to go and take my bath, because I hardly use cold water, I was just standing. From nowhere, the door of the kitchen uprooted. I thought it's somebody that maybe like armed robber is pushing the door. The door almost fell on me. I turned. I looked at the door and I just left that place to unhang towel to take the kettle. And the door just fell. I thought and said, I am Satan. So he wanted to come and knock me. It won't work. I went to the bathroom. I took my bath. My friend said she heard that noise so that she didn't know what was wrong. I thought that the kitchen door just operated from nowhere to hit me. So my brothers and sisters, I thank God because on Saturday, after Saturday morning, when we break with the anointing oil, I went home. Remember, man of God told us that as we are going, we should anoint our house very well. So even on the way, I've told my friend I want to go to the toilet. I even had issue with the keke man because I was very pressed. I was telling him, nature, please be fast. He said he's not going to increase his speed. So when I got home, instead of me to run into the toilet, I carried my anointing oil and anoint the whole compound. Before I went to the toilet, I was tooling all through yesterday. But when I came out, I was in my room. I just said, let me open my door blind. I noticed I saw big flies. The only thing I've seen in my room is cockroach and mosquito. I'll use insecticide. I've never seen even a small fly in my room before. I saw big flies and I was like, where are these flies coming from? My friend came out and saw it. I closed the window and I checked I didn't have insecticide, so I had to send for insecticide. These flies were big that they had this red head. I've never seen such flies before. So I had to I carried the anointing oil, splashed it on my window. I prayed before I used the insecticide on it. My people, I thank God because God has delivered me. The devil tried to stop me from my dream, but it never worked because I am here and I am delivered.
Put your hands together for the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Amen. All those rage, the power that don't want her to be free, want to cause problem for her, so that the power will hinder her from coming in. Be very sensitive. I said it earlier, the devil will always try to stop you from doing what will change or transform your destiny. Anytime you want to come for prayer, especially demons hate her back, seriously. Demons don't like her back. Once you hear, they hear her back, they say you are going to that place again, you want to give us trouble. And if you are not sensitive, you just give in to their tricks and antics. Don't chicken out. Amen. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Somebody shout a better fire. Can we just stand to our feet and begin to appreciate this great God for what he has done for us? Thank him for what he will continue to do on this mountain. Thank him for all the testimonies. Even if some did not share theirs, but I know that God has done something great in our life. Let's appreciate him. Appreciate him. Appreciate him. Thank him. And tell God, Lord, before the end of this program, before the end of this service, Father, locate me for a testimony. Open your mouth and say, Father, locate me this morning. Touch me in a new way. Do what no man has done. No man can do for me. Open your mouth and appreciate him. Say, Lord, surprise me. And for those that are watching us online, thank God, Lord, surprise me today. Locate me in this service. Do what no man can do for me. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' name we pray. For what the Lord has done, We soak all the testimony in the blood of Jesus. And louder. Louder.
I believe this is your word that you've been waiting for all night. Darwin, where are you?
See it. I am praying for somebody. Any power that I'll be oppressing you, let fire disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Let your amen roar like thunder. Let your amen roar like thunder. Let your amen roar like thunder. Somebody shall fire.
There is the Lord God of Elijah. Let my enemies destroy themselves. In the name